Where love is present, forgiveness is freely and joyfully offered to the penitent. Because God loves us so much, He delights in forgiving those who turn to Him for mercy. Last week's service emphasized the gracious aspect of God's love. Today, the emphasis is on His joy in forgiving. In the Old Testament lesson this morning, Moses reminds the Israelites of God's goodness and calls them to obey and serve Him. They in turn shall become a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. The Old Testament lesson this morning is written in the 19th chapter of Exodus, beginning at the second verse. After they set out from Rephidim, they entered the desert of Sinai, and Israel camped there in the desert in front of the mountain. Then Moses went up to God, and the Lord called to him from the mountain and said, "This is what you are to say to the house of Jacob, and what you are to tell the people of Israel. You yourselves have seen what I did to Egypt, and how I carried you on eagle's wings and brought you to myself. Now if you obey me fully and keep my covenant, then out of all nations you will be treasured, will be my treasured possession. Although the whole earth is mine, you will be for me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. These are the words you are to speak to the Israelites." So Moses went back and summoned the elders of the people and set before them all the words of the Lord had commanded him to speak. The people all responded together, "We will do everything the Lord has said." Here endeth the reading. The epistle lesson for this fourth Sunday after Pentecost and the text for this morning's sermon reveals how God's great love is especially revealed by His sending of His Son, Jesus Christ, to die for us while we were still lost. The epistle lesson will be read in unison just before the sermon. In the Holy Gospel this morning, Jesus expresses concern for the lost and confused multitudes and sends His disciples out to the villages of Israel to proclaim the kingdom of God. Please rise for the reading of the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel is written in the ninth chapter of St. Matthew, beginning at the 35th verse. Jesus went through all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, preaching the good news of the kingdom, and healing every disease and sickness. When He saw the crowds, He had compassion on them, because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then He said to His disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into His harvest field." He called His 12 disciples to Him and gave them authority to drive out evil spirits and to heal every disease and sickness. These are the names of the 12 apostles. First, Simon, who is called Peter, and his brother Andrew, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, Philip and Bartholomew, Thomas and Matthew, the tax collector, James, son of Alphaeus and Thaddeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed Him. These 12 Jesus sent out with the following instructions: "Do not go among the Gentiles or enter any town of the Samaritans. Go rather to the lost sheep of Israel. As you go, preach this message: the kingdom of heaven is near. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse those who have leprosy, drive out demons. Freely you have received, freely give." Here endeth the Gospel.